Hepatitis C is a silent epidemic in the United States. Because infection can take decades to produce symptoms, many of those infected do not know it. In the District of Columbia, an estimated 15,000 people are living with hepatitis C. If untreated, this liver-damaging infection can progress to liver cancer or liver failure. For people who also have HIV, this process happens more quickly. Verna Thompson was diagnosed with HIV and hepatitis C in 2006.
I went through that little pity phase, you know. I'm going to die. I'm not going to live, you know. And I went through all that, you know. But then I had to say, come on, baby, snap out of this, okay?
Now Verna participates in a program that partners scientists at the National Institutes of Health, or NIH, and doctors at DC health centers to tackle the city's HIV and hepatitis C epidemics.
When you have both HIV and hepatitis C, your outcome is much worse than if you have either one of them alone. So that makes it a very difficult patient population to treat.
Infectious disease researcher Shyam Kotalil at NIH's National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases says that many hepatitis C patients do not complete the standard treatments. These therapies are complex, lengthy, and can cause severe side effects.
If you don't do anything, a lot of these patients will develop liver failure and die. And that is a huge burden for the, not only for the clinics, for the insurance system, and for the healthcare system, and also for the patients, that they will not be able to get another liver.
Through the partnership, NIH researchers and their DC colleagues are conducting clinical studies to test new hepatitis C drugs. They focus on hard-to-treat patients, including those who have HIV.
So the newer studies are targeting objectives like shorter duration of treatment, using medications which have less side effects.
Dr. Teferi, an infectious disease specialist at Unity Healthcare, one of the DC-based agencies collaborating with NIH, says the treatment studies have yielded promising results.
The cure rate is very high, 97, above 90% cure rate.
In addition to hepatitis C treatments, study participants receive other care, including support to quit drinking and using drugs. Janelle Getches, Unity's founder, says the partnership has opened new possibilities.
What it has meant for our patients is that it's given them access into the highest quality care that one could get. I mean, how many people in this nation have access to this kind of possibility of care that NIH provides?
I can say I'm living with my HIV today and my hepatitis C, so I'm okay today with it. I'm okay. I've been clean, you know, stop drinking, stop drugging, stop everything. As long as I do what I'm supposed to do and maintain my regimen, I get to live today. So I'm okay with that.
The partnership continues to provide national leadership in the development and delivery of effective, safe, and convenient hepatitis C therapies.
The ultimate achievement we had is that we treated patients from over urban patient population, predominantly minority patients, who would not otherwise have been treated. And overall, these medications are so good that we are able to cure most of those patients.